ground control to Major Tom.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me? All right. Well, welcome to Top 8 on the loser side.
Top 8. Top 8 of an 8-man tournament.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll do that in the middle.
Okay. Manchild versus Todd, a.k.a. Crummy Fob.
They want us...
Oh, we're just going straight into it.
They want us close in so we can...
Oh, okay.
When we're outside of stuff. So anyway.
Just lean in here.
So, this is Manchild's debut of Sagat, actually. He's been kind of labbing him up, ready to go.
Yeah, yeah, I played him earlier in the tournament. Oh, is it? Yeah, I'm gonna, I need to lean back a little bit. Okay. Okay.
So far, it's
Good EX Tiger Knee. Yeah, he is my opponent. Yeah. All right, that was a good, maybe a little risky neutral jump there.
Yeah, just a little bit.
So. Oh my goodness. And goes Cody is in effect right now. Yeah, this is the way the matchup's gonna get played out, and oh, that works. That's great.
Yeah.
This is the way the matchup is going to get played out. Is Cody doesn't have that many options on getting in on Sagat, but it's basically over once he gets knocked down. We've all seen BJ Unchained versus Bon Chen. So
yes.
That one was that was a classic in like recent memory. Ooh, very good. It's missed the frame trap because Sagat wakes up a frame later.
Go to have a counter.
Ooh.
It seems that he's getting in, but he's not staying in. So I don't know if he's that confident with his aggression yet, or he's just respecting the Sagat too much. I'm not sure.
Oh, yeah. Me-Man's on point with these roundhouses, too. Yeah. It's very hard for Cody to get in there if he does it at the right time.
Grab.
Okay. Oh, we're in again. There we go. The late wake-up blowing up the crouch tech there. The frame trap for the crouch tech. All right. Ooh, that was a... That was a choice uppercut opportunity there. Oh, man.
Drops the link. But this is... Oh, ooh. Good uppercut. Reacting to the dash. That was good.
The audacity.
Indeed.
All right, but Cody's on a full stick of butter here. You're probably going to see an EX Long Knuckle at some point. Or EX Rocks. It's a good way to keep those fireballs neutralized. All right.
The
so Todd's in now.
Yeah,
he's still in. Oh, Me-Man. I don't know why Me-Man's going in here. But he can definitely stat if he wants to. Against a 2-bar Cody. Oh, very
nice
good uppercut by Todd.
EX Fireball, okay. Yeah. Man, he's just pushing
him
back.
Yeah, Me-Man is definitely playing the ranges correctly here. He's like keeping Cody at that stand roundhouse range. And,
good overhead. Oh, the Todd!
damn.
Salty Todd.
And I'm expecting an Elena switch here right now.
I would think so
as
well.
That Cody did not look ready.
Will he stay with... All right. I mean, it's best of five, so maybe he would stay just because. So who knows. So are we seeing Elena or seeing Rihanna?
Collusion. Counterpicking.
The American way.
All right, yeah. Todd's picking his main here of Elena. Let's not get it twisted. Oh, that was... yeah. Me-Man took the first game. Let's not get it twisted. Elena. Todd mains Elena.
Yes. For now.
So, possibly feels better about the Sagat matchup. Maybe he was just testing out a sub character.
Yeah, perhaps.
All right, we got the jumping in roundhouse there. That was a good distance. That's probably hard for Lena to anti-air there.
Nice Tiger.
Very good uppercut.
Oh, a nice Kyra uppercut there.
Ooh. Reads.
Yeah. I'm not
reading
sure if they're reads. A lot of these seems to be almost reaction, to be honest.
Yeah.
I mean, that EX I think he read, yeah. But like, good grab.
All right, Manchild playing these ranges right now. Oh, missed the fireball setup. That would have been another... Oh, my goodness.
The taunt.
And the second taunt.
Oh, man. This is just...
Cracker Jack's blowing it up right now.
He's,
Me-Man popping off in the background.
He's hungry. He's ready.
Yeah, he absolutely is.
Drops the
link. Got a little bit of a frame trap there. That doesn't link normally.
Oh, it doesn't. Okay.
Nah.
I guess it was the heavy kick, mm-hmm. wasn't it? Or the roundhouse.
Yeah, oh, very good sweep by Todd there. Misses the -5 uppercut. But yeah, still.
Nice
this
run
is
a
matchup definitely, whereas the last matchup, Sagat wanted to keep Cody at the... Oh my god.
Yeah, that's...
Hits him with the ultra. But whereas in the last matchup, Sagat wanted to keep Cody at the stand roundhouse range, that's more prime real estate for Elena than it is for Sagat.
I see.
Definitely.
All right, finally gets the whiff to DP. Now
then the healing right here. Yep. Gets a little bit of health back. He can be throwing fireballs right now, and it doesn't have any sort of meter to work with. Oh. Yeah, there we go. Yes, nice. Got the hard knockdown.
Oh, the wake-up ultra. And it's going to get blocked. Yeah.
Too hard of a read there.
Right. A little bit.
Using the uppercut to build optimal meter there. Very nice. And this is looking to be turned around a little bit.
Just
looking different
bit.
Than the first game.
Yeah. It looks like he's caught on, but...
Oh, very good air to air from Todd there.
Nice slide.
Sweep right on the tip. That would have been safe even if he blocked it.
Oh, good counter.
Yeah. Yeah, Mean Man's got his setups down. Or sorry, Man Child.
Yeah.
Also referred to as Mean Man.
He changed his name each week. Good FTC. He tries to punish with that, but...
The combo whiffing on Sagat there. Combo into the stand, strong into the breakdance. All right, and Scott's in the corner. This is pretty hopeless for Sagat. He can just stay outside of that range.
He's kind of downloaded.
Todd opting to not burn the meter there to finish the combo. And taking advantage of that very long-range three-frame crouching jab that Elena has. All
right, making it 1-1. So will he counter? Will he do an American counter?
Sagat. Stays with Sagat. No, his Sagat's looking good today.
I agree.
I think that's the good choice. I told him earlier that to play Sagat. So I'm glad that he's sticking to it. Oh, very good anti-air there. Sagat can be tricky. Sagat's roundhouse can be tricky to anti-air. He's got that like that shoulder stand roundhouse, like anti-air.
Yes.
It's like a huge hitbox.
Nice roundhouse.
Very good stand roundhouse. Oh, that was...
That was a weird hitbox.
Yeah. Choosing not to alter his hurtbox there.
He's suddenly DPing at ghosts. It's kind of too bad.
Maybe a little bit of nerves here.
Yeah,
we're seeing now that Elena's a very frustrating character to play against. It's very hard to press buttons against her. She's got that weird jump arc, too. Mii Man should be uppercutting a lot more than he is doing these 10 rounds. Oh, miss on the sweet punish there. That is about minus 10 where that hit.
Oh, there's the clip. Chooses the back dash. It should block, yeah.
Yeah, very good on Todd. Maybe the ultra ate the button
right.
or something, or maybe he just anticipated something to come out after he hit that combo.
Maybe.
Not enough confidence to finish it. So that was very smart to do that. Because the ultra did come out. All right.
Oh, I get the grab.
Mm. We're going to go back in here. Yeah, see right there. Normally where, like, Scott can't really do anything against that crouching jab at that range.
Right.
Oh, very good. Misses the combo. Gets uppercutted. Yes, Tiger knees, zero on block.
Yep.
Can't do anything, but he can throw, basically. Ooh,
beefy
jump in.
Ooh, red focus. I wonder if that was intentional.
Yeah. I will say it's a little strange, peculiar that Todd's using the red focus, because you can, off of that the breakdance move, you can combo into a fully charged level 2 focus and get the same crumple.
Oh, okay. Maybe he just doesn't know then.
Yeah. But I'm not particularly an Elena expert, so maybe he knows something that I don't.
Another ghost DP.
Oh, here we go. Oh, hits him with the overhead, drops the combo.
Nice knockdown. Good tech grab, but he's jumping in a lot. He's got a... Yeah, that's the fourth time in a row. He needs to...
He doesn't have to do these jump-ins. Like, Elena...
He can
just fireball. Just keep throwing the fireballs. There's nothing Elena can do about it. She's going to keep focusing. He should be throwing the fireball and then pushing her into the corner. Fireball dash. Something like that. Yeah, there we go. I like that he's moving forward now.
So much chip. Oh, no. He doesn't get blocked overhead.
Very clutch overhead from Todd there.
Someday we'll learn how to block that overhead here in Columbus, but... Nah, I'm just kidding. Never. So 2-1.
Until then. Okay. Am I good? I'm better? All right. Yeah, let me move back a little bit. Hard. Okay.
Yeah,
this is
all
of
these are 3 out of 5. Yep.
Yeah. All right, and Mean Man actually going ahead and making a switch over to Ryu here. I don't know how I feel about this. It's definitely, I think it's a better match for Sagat.
I agree.
Than it is for Ryu.
And especially since Todd also seconds Ryu, so he's kind of.
Yeah, this is true. This is really one of those things where like Ryu's crouching forward can be whiff punished so easily by all of Elena's moves. Yeah, she's just gonna do that all day. Crouching jab.
Sweep
when she sees him standing up. So this is just going to be footsies.
Right.
Stun.
Elena won't even care to trade with a DP on wake up, will she? Not with a lifelink like this. Oh.
Yeah. Oh, very good punish with the sand fierce there. That has a lot of startup. That was
Yeah.
He knew that was coming. Alright, throwing out a random sweep there, that could have been punished. Alright, very good end here. Yeah, that Ryu sweep is minus 10 at all ranges, so that's a free punish against Elena.
Oh, no DPs.
Throw because of Elena's funky hurtbox there. Oh, very interesting.
Yeah, the wheel through the fireball.
Pops off the healing, nothing Ryu can do about it. And here comes the combo. Very nice finishes in the stand short. Nice. Because the breakdance isn't the Link's tail, you can't shortcut it in this game. So it can be really hard to do it from the crouching jab.
Does get the knockdown finally, but tries to jump in. Mm-hmm. Overhead again.
Oh my gosh. Alright, that is it. Todd takes it, moves on in losers.
Alright, stay tuned. We'll see who we got next. I think Winners Finals is next on stream.
It should be whenever O'Reilly's here, so. Yeah, I. Alright, let me.
Just waiting for a phone signal. This is why I don't like challenge.
My phone bracket got that running right now. And right, that was 3-1.
Yes.
Okay.
This Sagat put on a good show.
I definitely liked his Sagat better, I think.
Yeah, because the thing is, he usually gets here before others do, and mm-hmm. So he's sitting here probably for a good hour each week in the lab.
It's clear that he's cultivated.
See you guys later.
Can you play Todd?
Yeah, Todd. Yeah. All
right. Moving on to losers semis. This is going to be Todd again.
No, they need to play on my computer. You need to do your winners finals.
Yeah. Oh no, we have time. It's only.
No, we don't. We only got an hour left.
This is 1-2.
These are best of 5, so. And then we gotta pack up.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess that's true. Hold on. Yeah.
Actually, wait, can you guys go over to the computer? Can you guys go to the computer? Yeah, Riley and I are gonna play. Okay.
Alright.
What do you
go by? Is this
Phil?
MN Phil. That's fine. Like capital N, capital. Okay. Capital M, capital N, Phil.
Alright.
Yeah,
so.
Alright, yeah, like I said, my name is Phil. I'm gonna be signing off now. Play a match.
Yep, good luck.
Yeah, I'm gonna play Riley over here, so alright. Thanks. See you guys over on the other window.
Indeed. But yeah, next up will be the winners finals. These two will most likely play each other. So we'll see on that. I might be able to get a caster here with me. There's 4 games left. Alright, joining me on the mic is Citadel. Let's just flip it off so it's
like that?
Yep.
Ah, sweet.
Yep, so here's Citadel joining me, the Keast. And we've got Ral as Ibuki versus Phil as Adon.
Yeah. Jeez, yeah. Ral's Ibuki's a lot of garbage anyway, so.
Yeah, that is actually the one thing is that his Ibuki is kind of a little weak on the footsies, and that's probably how Phil's going to take advantage of this.
And I mean, I don't know much about Phil's Adon, but he definitely knows the matchup real well, so I would imagine he's got this down.
Right. Yeah, just try to work it. Pick the job. But the thing is that if Ibuki. if Raoul gets that knockdown,
oh yeah,
it's almost over. So he just has to land it, but that's the problem he has.
Mm-hmm. I think Phil's the one who consistently beats Raoul when it comes to these things.
Yeah, it makes sense.
But yeah, and like, but you're right. The once he gets that knockdown, it's all over. The vortex is just it's just dumb.
Yeah, not quite. Oh, it goes for the meaty slide.
Mm-hmm.
That's just not gonna work. Thomas with the super, and that's another. That's a very, very quick game.
Yeah, that was quick. So,
yeah, that's one of those. Phil's like, I'll just post on Facebook. Let's run a tournament. I feel like I need more money.
Yeah, give me them dollars now. Okay, so what do you think would be something that Raoul could do to adjust to this matchup?
He needs to block more, in all honesty. He's used to being, like, really aggressive. Like he gets this, finally.
There's
that block.
Dropped.
I think he was waiting for a reaction,
oh,
to be
really?
Honest. Yeah, so now he's got the stun, and the round's his.
Yeah.
Just because he blocked a few times, finally. Mm-hmm. He's just YOLO too much, I think. That's all he's got to do. There's the time where you can wait on Adon, and he'll be able to strike. You got plenty of health.
Sure. Yeah. That's good. Yeah. Adon, I never noticed that about Raoul, actually. Huh. Maybe I should play that in my game.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah. There's that mix up again.
Here we go. Now what's the mix up? Now what's the setup? Oh.
That was a good EX to get out. Because if he did any of the normal other ones, he wouldn't have had the range to get out. But he could land the stun anyway. Yeah, just like that, he ties it up.
Wow, yeah, you're right. Jeez. So, what do you think Phil's going to do to adjust to the next game?
I mean, I'm not really sure. I think he just has to assume the option's going to be for some kind of knockdown.
Mm-hmm.
So he's going to...
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, it's just a bad Jaguar kick. Now he's stuck in corner. Nice wing.
Okay,
nice
there you
DP.
Go.
Honestly, I would have backed up at that point. Yeah, well, that
oh,
was a bad
good.
Dagger.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Here it comes now.
Yeah,
technical. Looking out for that. Yep.
Good block.
So that's the other thing, too, I noticed with Ibuki. She, like, I know the technical for or the delayed wake up was supposed to be something that would stop the vortex, but, you know.
They just, a lot of the good ones, they'll watch for the word reversal.
Mm-hmm.
And you can just react to that.
Sure, yeah, that's what I mean. Like, you know, the vortex isn't dead, per se.
Yeah, definitely not.
Ooh, did he commit? Nope.
Yeah, he's
I don't know.
Nerves, maybe, this time?
So here's
the thing. Adon doesn't, like, he has a okay overhead, but he doesn't really, unless he EX Jaguar kicks, he doesn't really have a, you can just crouch block low, and you're not going to get really knocked down by anything.
Right, yeah.
Like, there's the box there, and it's like, yeah, now Raoul's doing it right. Back up just a little bit until he sees something that's whiffed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just kind of like, you know, you're right, like, Raoul wants to play really aggressive, but I just don't think Ibuki allows him to be that aggressive.
Well, I mean, right then he was almost doing okay, but
yeah.
He got the stunt happened, though.
That's true.
Both players kind of adapting to each other.
Mm-hmm.
I think that was like a mispress button. Oh, good read on that. Actually, sorry, that was more of a reaction.
Sure. Here we go.
Yeah,
set up.
In the corner knockdown.
Oh.
He read it right and woke up. Good focus to get out.
Yeah, a lot of people would. I feel like, and I know I would. I would have tried to like done something there to like try to knock you out of the back dash or something like that. You know what I mean? Like, I forgot what he did already.
Oh yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah. Now at this point, if I was Adon, I would just not even go in. I mean, he'll try to fix out something safe like the Jaguar or the EX. I forgot what the wall jump cut thing is.
Sure, tooth, I think. I think that's
Jaguar tooth or
yeah.
Something like that. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So 2-1.
2-1. Yeah. Another fun thing I learned about that is if you're on the other side of the screen, even though on paper it looks like you would be able to react and like punish that. Apparently, because because it hits so low, it actually is plus.
Yes.
Which is really deceiving, like especially like on paper. So fun fact there.
Go to EX Tiger or Jaguar to wake up. Responds with her own DP.
Ooh.
I like the overhead block. I didn't realize that
was interesting.
Like that,
yeah, I didn't know that worked.
But yeah, Ryle's got him guessing about the DPs now, which is kind of where he wants to be.
Mm-hmm.
Adon does need to back up just a little bit.
Ooh, I don't know if that works.
Ooh, good throw attack, but.
There,
oh, that
nice.
Was,
yep,
he was
there
waiting
we go.
For that, too.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, that's what he was waiting for. I mean, Adon didn't really
have...
You'll
have to scoot it a bit so that you're more center with the camera.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, okay. Probably. Yeah, like, Adon didn't really have a lot of options to get back in on that point.
I don't think he really needed to be honest. I don't know. When it comes to Ibuki, what's wrong with walking? Like, both of her quick horizontal moves are either she does that dash or she does, like, a low.
Oh, right. Yeah, you're right.
Just kind of wait on that, maybe, but...
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, as I say all that, Adon's already at like no health, close to stun.
Ooh.
Adon does get out.
Mm-hmm.
But what a lead. Nice backdash after the kunai.
Yeah, I'd like to see Adon try to take control of the match again like he was earlier.
Oh, not quite. The problem is he doesn't have bar.
Yeah, you're right there.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So even if he was getting something wound up, it would have taken like, I don't know, a good three or four.
Sure, yeah.
Four
yeah.
setups maybe. Maybe just one or two more because he almost had bar, but. Surprise, surprise, Rowland Grand Finals.
No. And he's still got one more match. It's two.
I thought it was 3-2 already. My bad.
Well, you saw Phil there kind of thinking about it a little.
Yeah, either reflecting on it or...
And that's the thing that I really appreciate about Phil. He'll sit down and, like, he'll slow down and think, like, okay, what can I do this time?
Yeah. All right, now he's getting that pressure in
there
again.
There you go, yeah. See, this is what you want. You want to overwhelm, especially Rao as a player. That's like one way you can beat him.
Okay, knowing that he couldn't kill him, he decides to do a combo to keep him in the corner.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
He acts to chip out. Rao with a single bar, that might be enough.
Yeah, one hard knockdown, that's all it takes.
Oh, good.
Good.
Good lightning, Jaguar. Another good one.
And he's in some good...
Just as
I was going to say something.
Yeah. It just goes back. Rao knows that he can get someone paranoid enough that he can just sit and wait, and they're probably just going to throw an empty one.
Right, yeah. You know, and it's kind of strategic, too, to like, you know what, I'm going to do this and force them to respect, like, you know, give me some...
Oh, there's our knockdown, though.
There it is.
Oh,
here
there's
we go.
The hit, and that's it.
It doesn't matter, yep.
He gets the wrong 50-50.
He's so quick, man.
All right, both respecting each other off the bat.
Yep, dancing around.
Reads the low and goes for a Jaguar kick. But the EX one misses.
He wants to stay in.
Good grab.
Here we go.
Yeah, I think rinse and repeat.
Yep, then he went low again. He's trying to do an instant overhead there.
Yeah, kind of whiffed. I think it's a little harder to get off of her, if I'm not mistaken, but...
Yeah, I think her hurt box is a little smaller, so it's a little more difficult to
does
get
EX
to.
Jaguar out. That was good.
Oh,
there's the stun.
Oh.
But I don't... Well, actually, she probably, can't kill him.
No. Nope.
Not yet.
He's got to be careful
chip
about
out.
Chip. Yep.
Blocked in the corner. Right.
Well.
All right, so as my past self was trying to say, Rao in the grand finals yet again.
yet again. Jeez.
So next up we'll have Phil versus the winner of Todd and Henry, which are both playing right now. So we'll be taking a little break at the moment.
Yeah.
But that's pretty even. Both explosive characters.
For sure. Yeah, once each character was able to get started, then it was just a matter, it just took a couple of good setups and reads, and then it was all over.
Ibuki is definitely the aggressor, like we were saying, but Adon definitely has enough counter-aggressive that he can get his own thing going. But, yeah, Adon's probably not going to get the first move off, but he'll get the counter move off, and then he'll get the setups and so on, so that's what you got to kind of rely on. But if Ibuki reads that, just chooses to end something early, so it looks like it's a drop. Whiff Jaguar kick, and then, Jaguar, shoot. I forgot the name.
Rising Jaguar.
Yeah, Rising Jaguar.
Yeah, and you can see it in that matchup too, or just like there were, you know, just enough whiffed specials that like Raul was like, all right, here we go.
Like, oh man.
Which knockdown am I going to use on you today?
Right. I only got like 5. Don't worry about it. Although, let's look at it realistically. So, I mean, you've got throws, right?
Right.
And then you've got the... Well, I guess you have the... I guess the problem is the ones that combo into the EX slide grab thing. I forget what it's called offhand because I don't know my ninja techniques. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Is it just called neck breaker?
Yeah, it's called neck breaker.
Whatever.
Although when she did it against Don, it was like his hair instead of...
So, hair breaker.
She cut his hair. Right
here at the scalp line. Oh, that's
funny. I guess that one's the perfect part, but all the other knockdowns are just lows. I mean, she doesn't have an overhead that can do it, or...
No, but speaking of her overhead, like, very, very slow. However, like, reaps a lot of rewards if it hits, because, like, he can go straight into... Or Ibuki, that is. Ibuki can go straight into crouching jab and then start her whatever that's called, right. Tsumuji loops and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Plus it's a nice it's a jumping overhead too, so they can't.
Right. So
they can't do like a crouching light to usually try to counter her strengths
right.
and stuff. It just crushes it, which is great.
Yeah, any of the crouch techs too. Most of them probably wouldn't hit. And who stand techs anymore? I know I don't.
Yeah.
I probably should implement that, but... Nah, but overall, good matches, like, here. Like, both of them students of the game, and they're really good.
Yeah, question is, all right, so we've got Todd Elena versus Henry. I think he's been using mostly...
He's been using Rolento tonight. He actually whipped out his Geef against my Chun-Li. Chun-Li came out, and... yeah, like, not much I can do about it.
It looks like Todd won, since I see an Elena victory screen.
Yep. Okay, so we got Todd here, who plays primarily Elena and has a Ryu.
Yes, he does.
Yeah.
So it's going to be Todd and MM Phil?
Yeah, it'll be Todd and Phil.
Yeah, MM Phil.
Does Todd go by anything besides Todd?
Nope.
Todoro.
Oh,
Todd,
yeah, Todoro.
Todd,
yeah.
And then Oro. All one word.
1D or 2?
1D.
1D, yeah.
Yeah. I like to point out that the shout-outs to Ragnarok for his stream. No. I like looking at it and seeing how we look in this direction to see the stream and the players, but it's looking away from... The other cams,
yeah,
and stuff.
Yeah, from the camera.
So who knows where things are? And then there's, like, usually a game behind us, so if we don't have commentators, it almost looks like we're... have more players. Like, oh, we don't have commentators, but we're going to show more, player perspective shots, if you will.
Right, yeah.
Which would actually be hilarious if, like, we're... Like, a serious match is going on, there's, like, finals, it's not being commentary, but then this one is, like... Rage, like, sticks are being thrown in the air and, like, shattered and stuff. People want to know what's going on in that game.
Yeah, right.
It's just Marvel. It's like, not Marvel, even, like, a real... It's not even, like, a serious Marvel game. It's, like... It's, like, the low tiers. You got your, Yeah, you have your Jill, like, Shua Gorath or something like
that.
Yeah. Up against Arthur.
Oh, man. Man, I haven't played that game in a minute.
All right, so my team I wanted to try to learn was Ryu, Chris, Nemesis.
Oh, really? Oh, that's... Oh, man, that's weird.
Nemesis had some... Yeah, I kind of wanted to go for, like... it was mostly the Ryu with the two assists. Like,
sure, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, because you get the fire in the hole with Chris to get the flame pillars to go up. And then if they block wrong, you got, like... Because in Ultra Marvel, Ryu's overhead actually does combo into everything.
Oh, I didn't know that. Huh.
So you could actually get some stuff going on with that. And then Nemesis is just... His launcher just, like, covers half screen, so you can actually just use it as a flat-out punish.
Sure,
to get
yeah.
And things like that, too.
Yeah, I mean, I never really got into it. I mean, my team was... The first team I played as was Dante, Amy, and Morgan.
Okay.
So I used course, this was when I was such a scrub and like, oh, I want to give all the meter to Dante so he can do all the specials
and all that
stuff. Yeah. Interesting. So,
Phil's playing Sakura.
Phil's playing Sakura, and Todd's, as expected, Elena.
I think the reasoning is that if you think about Sakura's normals, especially her crouching medium kick,
the
range kind of does beat out a lot of Elena's pokes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And Elena has a lot of good buttons, too. A lot of them can lead to a lot of different, you know, follow-ups, and she has a real decent overhead, too, if I remember correctly.
Sakura or?
Elena.
Elena does, but a lot of them are kind of slow. They were just, I still think people just really aren't used to it yet.
Sure, yeah. I see what you're saying. Better,
but. All right, so here we go. Losers Finals, game one. We have both. Oh, nice cross under there, the dash under.
I think what it was is that Elena used either medium or hard, whatever that is. Is that mallet smash? Or?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah,
it's mallet smash is the uppercut.
Oh, okay.
I think the rhino or something like that. Anyways, point is.
Either way, yeah, I think because of Sakura's small hitbox that, like, Elena went over. I don't know, whatever.
Something like that. Anyways.
So definitely a lot of spacing here. Both players wanting to choose their moments, it would seem.
Todd's doing really good at those quick normals for the anti-airs.
Healing?
Yeah, more of an in-your-face one just to get a little bit. It's just that a commanding lead just stands out.
Ooh.
Oh no.
What was that? I don't know. See, I don't know how much I like that.
Yeah,
I mean, because he burnt some meter. You know, you could have saved that going into this next round. I don't know. But, so Phil here trying to regain some ground, it would seem.
Yeah, just playing the fireball game. I don't really know what he's trying to fish for. So this is exactly what Elena wants, unfortunately.
Right, yeah. Any sort of projectile heavy character, you know, she'll just focus that.
And especially what you gotta remember too is like usually you don't want to focus all the time because you'll get hit by one and then you lose all that health. But Elena doesn't care as long as you get their Ultra 2 filled up.
Okay, here we go. Now first character.
No, drops it. Yeah, not gonna heal yet.
No. Here we go.
I like it. The full screen heal. Knowing the range of the fireball.
Yeah, that was smart.
Gets hit, but gets enough health back, though. Good grab. Back.
No,
yeah,
wow.
Do it.
Yep, that was enough. So kind of mixed feelings here, you know. You got the fireball game that you can do. And as you were saying, you're right. You absorb too many, you know. And then take one. All it takes is one hit, and then that's all gone.
Ooh, does jump back in time.
Had enough meter. Three bars, though.
Yeah. Although, to be honest, I think Sakura can get bar pretty easily. Like, comparatively speaking. Good block.
Here we go. Good jump in. Here we go.
Yeah, nice damage. Tries that traded.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it looked like he did that crouch under again.
Oh, here we go.
He gets clipped.
Healing.
Damage the heal. If it's just a little bit.
You know, and that could be the difference here. Let's see.
It usually is.
Oh, now ultra? No, right. Too much damage scaling.
Right. Does the setup to throw. Oh, he clipped him, but didn't get anything off. Oh, wow, good. Good EX DP. First game going to Phil. This is a,
So this is pretty close. This is pretty close.
It's a strange matchup.
Yeah. I mean, it's pretty close, and, you know, just minor adjustments, I would imagine, would be needed to make here.
Yeah, something like that. I'm not really. Oh man, missed the block again. It's really hard to deal with that Elena pressure.
Mm-hmm.
Does block the overhead, does get the tech grab, which is nice. But Sakura does need to get out.
Yep.
Which it does, but... Oh, wow, okay. It does stop the focus dash in.
Oh, nice empty jump into crouching short there.
It did not have bar, so it's going to use Ultra. Time to heal. Oh, wow, cancels on that overhead. Okay, we got our slide. Them hooves.
Wait, she's supposed to be a goat or something? Like, what is
that? An antelope, I believe.
Gazelle. Yeah.
One of those guys.
Oh, man. Now they're bells, stunned. I was just going to say.
Yeah, it just goes for big damage to keep him in. Oh, it gets the reset, too.
Oh, man, are we going to... Yep, there it is. Wow, perfect.
I think it was, like, one bar used or something.
I think so, yeah. I think one bar was used there.
It's pretty alright.
No, yeah, not bad.
Would have been better if you had done.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I think better players probably would have been able to figure out how to do it without any bar.
Oh, cripes.
Okay, alright. So, Todd working on his own?
I don't think he's going to get the first perfect. Yeah, there's our EXDP we're waiting on. Gets the cross up, too. Alright, does manage to avoid stun.
Yep. Yeah.
But now back at the neutral, but... Phil does have to make something happen to force out that healing.
Mm-hmm. Good move on Todd to cancel that.
Good move on Phil to cancel that.
All the pokes.
Yeah, there's our grab and heal.
Here we go. Not quite a full one, but...
Yeah, can't get one against Sakura. The forward dash is too good.
Mm-hmm. Another empty jump.
Good damage.
Oh, there we go. Squeezing out every bit of damage.
Yeah, not gonna kill, but enough to get into... Oh, nice wake up.
Oh, here we go.
Wake up to heal, now he's no longer in chip range. Even if he does get hit by full DP, just let it rip.
A little bit of... Not quite
a
scramble. Here we go.
That should be it. That was a bad time to slide.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he was already crouching, too. It's like...
Right, yeah. So what is it,
2-1?
2-1, I think?
Or 2. Yeah,
0-2. Okay, so Phil with the advantage here. And Todd sticking with Elena for this last one.
I agree with it. Ryu against Sakura is not good, to be honest.
Really? I guess I just don't know that.
Yeah,
she
just kind of gets in and then, like... the crouching medium kick outranges Ryu's crouching medium kick, so like he just has no ground spacing.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I can see that.
And then it's not even like a true block string at that range, so she can actually EX DP through the fireball on reaction after the medium kick's blocked. So it just kind of becomes a little bit of a nightmare.
Sure.
Todd with a great lead right now though.
Yeah, and he doesn't have to do anything too risky here. Yeah, just, I think those are jabs.
They are.
Dancing around in neutral. There we go. A couple overheads, another overhead.
Oh, gets the jump in. Boom, boom, boom. Okay.
Set up the fireball. Oh, no.
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised by that too.
Yeah.
Maybe it's because Elena had a bar for the better EX DP or
the
something.
The DP, right, yeah, that could have been the thing.
Nice slide on the empty jump.
How many of those is he going to do? Oh, there we go.
One too many.
Yep.
Gets focused immediately.
Another fireball setup, maybe?
Yeah, now it is a fireball setup.
There we go.
Oh, ooh. Drops it. Right, it's the grab and neutral jumps correctly, but doesn't get the follow-up afterwards. Life lead still in Elena's now. Now she's just going to let it full heal. Oh, I'm surprised.
Yeah, he had to cancel that in order not to eat the fireball there.
Yeah, I don't think the fireball would have done that much damage compared to it, but...
I think it might have been just the VX version that... I mean, it doesn't matter, though.
Yeah, I suppose. But yeah, Victor goes the...
Alright, so match point for Phil here. Oh, no way to cancel it. What's the punish?
Yeah, I'm Unfortunately, doesn't have. I had to use the X meter there for that. I think he had probably done a better punish than that, but. Not really.
I mean, I think that's a good punish, though. I mean, look at the life lead now. And if Todd just plays a little patiently, he might be able to just edge this one out.
Right. But. Again, that damage from Sakura is just really good. There it is.
Yep. You're right. Maybe that's what he was looking for last time. There we go.
Good pokes.
All right, so Todd was able to take one.
He's still in there, folks. He's still in there.
He's still got it. Going right back in it. All right, so. Again, it's just this funny little dance right here at the very beginning, and then both players just take off once they get started.
All good focus counter there. Mm-hmm. Goes for the empty jump or the neutral jump setup. Good grab.
Nowhere to backdash there, Elena. Ooh, she has a great backdash, I feel like.
Elena, it's pretty good. I mean, obviously, it's no Rose. Good overhead, but it gets countered immediately.
Yeah.
But the damage is too big here. Mm-hmm. It's probably just that Dragon Punch where it comes down to, because it's like, you see the whiff, you do it, so they can't really do anything afterwards, and then you're outside of the range anyway, so it creeps you in, which is great.
Sure, yeah.
So we'll probably see that same distance again. Backs up to that distance.
Fireball set up, yep.
Probably the neutral jump setup again, yep. And then that's the distance she wants right there.
Mm-hmm. Nope, now Sakura's turn to be in the corner.
No heal.
Oh.
Oh, because it was right by the corner. He could have just walk up DP'd.
Sure, yeah.
Would have taken a lot out of it. It doesn't want a little heal at this point. Although, it might have been the better move. We'll see, but.
He's definitely going to want to score a knockdown here soon or something.
Yeah, I think Sakura just knows that that's what he's going for. He's just going to keep crouching low.
Right.
Just wait for the time to punish. Lock the overheads as they come.
Well, there it is.
There it is. Phil goes on to grand finals.
Coming in.
Commentating going, guys.
Did you want in?
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Here, hold on. Here, I'll.
All right. Yeah. Set it all, piecing out. Joining me for grand finals, we've got Henry, whose tag I don't remember what he goes by.
Well, that's kind of weird. I hear Echo.
Yeah, that's how it goes.
So, what do you
just gotta pretend you're casting in a cave.
So what do you think of that match?
I liked how Todd was kind of playing it. Just I feel that it's the matchup that kind of lost it for him, to be honest. Like
I felt like it's pretty even. Just like Sakura, like once she knocks you down, she like so many options, you know, mix you up.
Yeah, but like a lot of her. All right, so her countering medium kick kind of forces Elena to like can't whiff any of the like lights. But if Elena whiffs any of the like mediums, then it's a free DP anyway, or a free, I forget her actual Tatsu move,
what the name is.
That's what I feel like. It's just all about Elena landing the overheads, but the overheads themselves aren't that safe if they're read correctly. So
The overhead from the
Elena. You'll have to scoot in a little bit.
Yeah,
no, this way. Yeah, so the camera gets
us. Oh, the camera? You didn't know.
You're just making it worse, man. You gotta go toward me.
Oh. Towards you.
Yeah,
okay,
we gotta pretend we're like a family or something.
Okay, well, I didn't know there was like a lag. Delay. Okay, now we got the Pikachu Ibuki versus Old Man Gen. And the button checking right now.
Yes.
Oh, we know Todd. Well, I mean, Phil got a bunch of characters in this fold, though. He can play again. He got, We just saw Sakura earlier, and his main is Adon. Oh no, he's gonna pick Adon, okay.
Yeah, because I was saying in the last cast, when Riley lands that knockdown, he's a god. I think his weakness is gonna come down to the footsies, and that's how Phil was actually winning the games before, because he did actually make it 3-2, and it was just because he was just out footsing with Adon. And then Ryle decided to just like block occasionally, and that kind of stopped it. So
let's see how Adon deals with the Bukis mixed up. He cannot get knocked down. Okay.
Right.
All right. Good grab. Empty jump low.
Oh, I like that. Getting over and then getting the grab up.
Nice bait. Overhead. Pretty safe. Nice punish. Oh, he missed that jack right up the cut.
But that desperate slide. But it does kind of seem like whoever lands the knockdown is probably going to win the round.
Yeah, one knockdown from Valley, and if we can play the game.
Yeah, but I mean, even Phil's Adon in this moment, he's just kind of getting it too.
Yeah, he got that weird jump arc that looks kind of tricky. You know, right. Kind of jump in front of you and not.
I also like how he's using the light Jaguars to like cross him up, not for the cross up hit, but just so they get somebody on the other side so they're not really sure about the block or so on. Good back dash out. This is one time when the Ibuki's really patient, doesn't really go for it.
Nice.
Does keep getting grabbed.
Oh,
though.
Nice. Here it comes.
Alright. Oh, good.
Oh, you missed the ultra right there.
Aw.
I'm doing the valley in the corner.
This is gonna be. Oh no!
Oh
there's the kunai.
Kunai out of nowhere.
Would the EXDP gone through that?
Yeah, EXDP would definitely beat it.
Okay.
I think he would try to dash under and do ultra.
Yeah. To secure the kill.
Oh, he would beat it out. Okay, that's fine.
Alright, here's our knockdown.
Oh, nice.
She's the lightning dagger out. Responsible for her own DP. Reads at that time with a command grab.
Oh, nice block.
Yeah, that was a great block.
Got out of it. Good choice.
Both pretty even. Although, Ryle does have the bar. Oh, he dropped it.
Oh, you gotta chip him out.
Oh,
okay,
yeah,
chip
him out anyway. Alright.
Ryle made a good choice
on that. Alright, game one going to Ryle. Alright, will he stay Adon? Probably. I mean, I don't know who else would even be good in this matchup that Phil uses to be like.
Okay, so Adon trying to build a little meter and try to bait Valley out.
But nice
uppercut on the overhead.
Yeah, that was a great reaction.
Empty jump, loaded combo. Okay. So you gonna do next? Oh, you gotta try to standing medium punch.
I like how when he sees the kunai, he'll EX Lightning Jaguar, and it looks like it puts him just out of range of the slide, which has been, as long as he blocks, he has never heard a block, but.
Now with the Adon going a little ham, a lot of uppercuts right there.
But that's what happened the first round last game.
Now he's just matching out uppercuts, trying to make Rally scared.
Yeah, he just has to be.
Ooh, red focus? Red. Okay, interesting.
Yeah, I wonder if that was a mistake.
Oh, he missed his combo? Okay.
I wonder if he was trying to bait it out a lightning. We'll just say he missed it.
Oh, you got the one frame link down? Okay, here comes the knockdown. What are you gonna do? Front or the back kunai? What are you gonna do? Oh, nice.
Yeah, again, that
EX. He should have done the neck break to catch that, but oh well.
Nice sweep.
Oh, good counter.
Oh, that does a lot of damage.
Oh, here comes.
I thought that was over with that whiff.
Oh, he baited it out. That's very nice.
Yeah, that was. Tying it up.
Now it's 1-1.
That cackle.
1-1. 11:30. We might have a time for one money match after this.
Yeah, you might.
Hey, Todd, you still want to do the receipt money match? The pizza receipt? Okay, we'll do that. We'll stream that.
No, I don't know if they'll have time to. Just, you know, we have to be out of here by midnight today.
Oh, we have to be out of by midnight. Oh, yeah, okay, yeah. That shit takes a lot of time.
Save it for the Kumite next week. Because we're going to do a Raoul farewell Kumite next Tuesday. So that will be recording. After Unreal's done, but solid first round getting chipped. I mean, realistically, Phil's just gonna reset the bracket. yeah. and ruin any chances you would have had in that match anyway. Does get the slide off, but oh, nice focus.
Oh, he missed his combo, but he got to get a reset off that. Nice.
Oh, there's our stun.
Okay, here we go.
Wow, that was
2-1.
Quick. 2-1.
Getting that momentum. I see what he's doing. Come on, Rally, I think I picked Rose. Everybody got a pocket Rose now. Oh, nice counter hit. Very nice. Oh my god, he's going ham with a Jaguar kick. So, looks like Phil's like mixing up his game every time he plays. Like, round two, he was like doing a lot of Jaguar uppercut. Now he's doing like all the Jaguar kick.
Yeah, he's kind of... Sorry. He's kind of in his head, I would say. Although...
Oh, he's going a
one mistake, though. I mean, good block.
Oh, good block.
He's
exactly
really good at blocking those, actually. Does the X, which is safe.
Oh, nice block also for that. I mean, yeah.
Interesting focus backdash there.
Oh, here comes the big punish. What are you going to do? Okay, basic.
Yeah, goes for the knockdown so you get the mix up. Goes for that, just a normal cross up.
Oh, red focus.
Oh, wow.
Where's that meter?
Yeah.
Could have saved that for next round.
Yeesh.
Just waste. Why did you waste that red focus? Okay.
Oops.
Oh, really? You can anti-air that by doing a jab? Okay. Oh, nice.
Oh, wow, I anti-air that too.
Oh, he tried to bait the counter hit with that little hammer kick. Oh, really? Drop the combo? Caught him mashing? Oh, my God. Riley's scared. Now Riley lost. He might be too faded.
Oh, man.
That was a good match.
Well, he just... Oh. That was just a reset.
Is this three?
Yeah, it's a reset.
Wait, that was a reset. You're the winner, right? No, you're the winner, right? Oh, okay, reset. Yeah, my bad.
Okay, we reset. I'm confused.
Even everyone but me and the players knew what's happened. So that was a reset, so now we're back at 0-0. Since Riley was waiting in the winners, so we're just not used to doing this on Wednesday. That's what it is. Alright.
Yeah. Well, we used to do it on Wednesday before it was on Tuesday.
You're right, right. Long ago.
Todd, do you want to commentate or no? No? He's probably salty.
Probably.
Oh, nice punish. I like that. Dash under. Oh, he tried a little penguin kick.
Yeah, it looks like Riley's been kind of making the adjustments. He's just backing off now that he has the life lead. He's going to wait for Adon to make that mistake. Just like that right there. Good tech. Just waiting for that one moment.
Uh-oh. What are you gonna do? A random wake up ultra!
Oh, man. That Xbox Live tech.
Yeah. Rallied. Oh, man. Oh, my God. He's punishing everything. Guessing everything right.
He's hungry for that
one. Oh, he's trying to do instant overhead. I see. Wow.
He's guessed right.
Rally is not doing any of the safe jumps at all.
Yeah, apparently not.
Ooh.
Just roundhouse.
How many beards you have, Rally? Really?
Maybe that's the problem.
How much did you smoke? How much did you smoke, Rally?
We got... First game, very handily by Phil. Still has to win two more, though. Oh, man, in the corner.
Okay, here we go. What are you going to do with the setup?
The empty jump setup.
Jump, jab. It should have went empty jump low. Nice.
Good grab.
Whoa, what was that?
Got him out though. Yeah, it's like you're saying, he's not going for the like a heavy neck breaker or something to try to punish that. Although he might not be able to though. I'm not really sure. Both playing very safe ranges.
Oh my god, here comes the big. Oh, you missed the combo, Valley. Come on, what is that, Valley?
And then the ultra finish.
Damn, that quicker. And Adon likes beating up on women. Actually, little girl.
Yeah.
High school girl.
Does get out of the corner.
Let's see if,
well, that was interesting.
Bill can take this 6 games straight.
Oh, he tried to hit him out of that.
Counter hit and comboed off that. Oh. Oh, counter hit off that shit too. Yes. Oh, no.
Ugh.
Oh, crouching medium punch.
Man. Yikes, 5 in a row. We got the last
match.
Possibly, yeah.
Wow.
Unless Riley goes Super Saiyan. Oh, good focus.
Nice, I like that.
Yeah, that was really good.
Oh, he got the Jaguar kick pressure. Okay.
Oh, he does manage to land on the
hit on the radar. What's he gonna do after this? Okay. Trying to do the overhead. Oh, he's trying to do the cross up one.
Yeah, Phil has been really good about his blocks. Misreads an ultra. That's... Yeah, I was going to say, I don't think it's quite death, but...
Yeah, he's about 2 chip damage. You can kill him. Oh, Kuna. Oh, here comes a comeback.
Down,
what are you gonna do?
Oh, just the X Jaguar.
Direct uppercut.
Tournament. Point.
Oh, last round. See if Phil can take it. Oh, Danny hard kick. Oh, Valley doing his yellow uppercut.
Oh, the whiffs punish.
Okay, now Valley's copying Todd. I mean, not Todd, Phil's playstyle.
Oh, gets the backdash.
Oh.
I like the
really?
Double air trade.
Oh, here comes the game for the chip.
And that does it.
Good job, guys.
So there we go. Phil wins the 8-man tournament. 6 in a row. That's pretty bloody. But yeah, that concludes our tournaments for today. Join us next week where we'll do Under Night, as well as our Ultra Street Fighter 4 Kumite for Raul. We'll be leaving Columbus, so that'll be fun. And that's about it. Keith signing out. Have a good week. Peace.